Hello. Let's learn how to make a culotte jumper from this video. Let's look at the highlights of this garment first. This is a gathered waist seam and bust darts. The garment is quite loose fitted at waist and hips. Armholes got cutaway shapes. I've added decorative stitches on the neckline and armhole edge. We will use 3 cm wide facings to finish the neck and armholes. Facings are fused. An invisible zipper is attached at the center back. Small hook is attached at the top of the zipper. There are slant pockets on both side seams. Also, the legs are quite wide, and the leg opening is finished with a 3 cm clean finished hem. There are 2 waist darts at back. I'm using the fitted basic block to create this design. First, copy the front and the back blocks up to the waist level with darts. I've copied back block onto this paper. I already cut around the copied front block. Now, let's do some changes to the block according to the design of the jumper. Let's work on the front pattern. There is no dart at front waist on this design. Therefore, I'm going to pivot that allowance to bust dart. I reduce the width of the waist dart by 2 mm on each side. And connect those 2 points with the dart point. Now I copy the front block from the point marked as A to the point marked as B onto this paper. Now transfer the waist dart volume to bust dart like this. Now draw the new bust dart and smoothen the waistline. Mark the center of the bust dart and draw a line to bust point. Mark 3 cm towards the side seam from the bust point on that line. Draw the new bust dart. Now, I add 5 mm to side seams from armhole to waist level on both patterns. Also raise the underarm point by 7 mm. Now, mark 2.5 cm inwards from the shoulder end. Take shoulder width as 6 cm from that point. Also drop 3 cm down from center front neck and draw a perpendicular line to the center front line. Let's draw the new armhole shape and the neck shape at front. Do these changes on the back pattern. Mark 2.5 cm inwards from shoulder end. Draw the new armhole shape. Take shoulder width as 6 cm from that point. And then, mark 2.5 cm down from center back neck and draw a perpendicular line to center back. Draw the new back neck shape like this. Now I reduce the width of the back waist dart by 2 mm from each side. Drop the dart point by 2.5 cm. Draw the new dart connecting those new points. Fold the waist dart like this and draw a smooth curve on the waistline. Trace the dart end. Now open the dart and redraw the dart ends. Fold the bus dart like this. Smoothen the side seam. This is our center front line. I will add seam allowance to the front pattern now. 7 millimeters at front neck. 1 centimeter at shoulder. 7 millimeters at the armhole curve. One centimeter at side seam. 1 centimeter to dart. This dart is a little bit wider than usual. So, I'm going to remove the inner part and going to make the garment less thick on dart area. I recommend you adding around 2 centimeters at side seam in case you want to change. 1 centimeter seam allowance at waist seam. Mark the bust point. This is our center back seam. Mark the dart point. Add seam allowance to back pattern as same as I did on the front pattern. Additionally, add 1 centimeter to center back seam. Measure the center back seam length without seam allowance and record it for future use. It is 37 centimeters on this pattern. Now I measure the length from armhole to bust dart and transfer that length to backside seam and add a notch mark there. I'm going to add facings to necklines and armholes. Let's work on them now. First, I copy the front neckline to this edge of the paper. And then copy the front armhole. Draw 3 centimeter parallel lines to armhole edge and neckline edge. Also, create back facing panels using the same method. Just put double notches at back armhole and facing. And cut around. Now we are done with the top part of the jumper. Let's work on the culotte. To create this part, we need 3 main measurements. Those are, crotch depth, hip, and waist to hem measurement. Waist to hem measurement is based on your preference. Crotch depth is 27 centimeters. The calculation for this measurement is displayed on screen now. Hip is 98 centimeters. I invite you to watch measuring your body video to take basic measurements correctly. The hem of this culotte is placed in between knee and ankle. In this case, waist to hem is 77 centimeters and hem circumference is 88 centimeters. Now I draw a line roughly 1/3 of the width of this paper. And then draw a perpendicular line at this edge. This is the waistline. I add 2 centimeters to crotch depth, which is 29 centimeters now. And mark that 29 centimeters from the top edge on this line. Also, the waist-to-hem measurement, which is 77 centimeters, is marked from the top edge on this line. And draw perpendicular lines on each point to both sides. Now I mark 1/4 of the hip measurement on this line. And then add 5 centimeters ease. Now I draw a perpendicular line to top and bottom lines from that point. I mark a point at the center of this line. Now mark the front crotch width on this line. It is 10.25 centimeters. And draw a perpendicular line to hem from that point. Then draw a line at 45 degrees from this point. Mark 4 centimeters on that line. Now draw the front rise connecting these points. Now we are going to construct the slant pocket at side seam. I mark pocket width at top is 4 cm, and pocket opening is 15 cm. First I mark 4 cm from the side seam. Place the edge of the ruler at this point, and place 15 cm value of it on the side seam line. And draw the pocket opening like this. Mark 3 cm down from the lower edge of the pocket opening. Place the ruler, roughly at 1/3 of the length of the pocket opening from bottom. Mark a point 12 cm from the side seam like this. Now draw the pocket bag shape like this. Extend these points out from the pocket bag. Now add the seam allowance. I add 1 cm seam allowance to side seam. Four centimeters at hem. 1 cm at inseam. 1 cm at front rise. 1 cm at waist. We can draw the back pattern on the front. It only differs at crotch area and at the leg opening. So, I draw it on this front using a blue pen. Now I mark back crotch from this line. It is 4 cm from the front crotch end. And mark 4.5 cm on this diagonal line. Now draw a curve, connecting those points and blend with the center point of the crotch depth. This is the 1 cm seam allowance for back rise. Now add 1 cm seam allowance for back inseam. Now connect it with the hemline. I redraw the front pattern using a red pen, so it will be easy to identify. Cut from outer edge of the pattern. This is the back inseam and this is the front inseam. Now I am going to trace pocket panels. First draw two outer edges of the pocket. Drill this point. Trace the inner shape of the pocket bag. Add 1 cm allowance to this diagonal line, which is our pocket opening. Cut two pieces of the pocket bag like this. Add two notches at the start and end points of the pocket opening. Cut along this line. Now trace the seam allowance line of the pocket opening to culotte. When we cut the front pattern, we need to cut along this line. So, I marked it as front. For back, it needs to be cut along this straight line. Now we are done with the patterns. Let's mark the pattern pieces for cutting. I'm going to cut the both front and back patterns using this same block. So I mark details like this. Cut two pieces like a pair for front. Cut two pieces like a pair for back. This is the back bodice. Cut two pieces as a pair. This is the back neck facing. Cut one pair. This is the back armhole facing. Cut one pair. This is the front bodice. Cut one piece. Place the center front edge on the folded edge of the fabric. This is the front neck facing. Cut one piece. Again, place this edge on the folded edge of the fabric. This is the front armhole facing. Cut one pair. This is the pocket lining. Cut one pair. This is the pocket bag. Cut one pair. Now let's mark the zipper length on the center back. The length from neck to waist, along the center back is 37 centimeters. Finished length of the zipper is 48 centimeters. So I mark remaining 11 centimeters on back culotte like this. This is the fabric from which I am going to make this culotte jumpsuit. It is 2 meters in length and 1.45 meters in width. As linen gets shrunk when washing, I pre-washed this fabric and ironed. First, I fold the fabric like this. Draw and cut the back culotte. Mark the zipper end. I also mark the pocket opening placement, so we can match the notch marks when sewing the side seam. Now I cut the back details from this pattern, so it reveals the front block. Now I place the front onto the folded fabric, and cut around. Mark the necessary notch marks on the fabric. Now I fold the fabric like this, and place the center front edge of the front block onto the folded edge. I place back pattern like this. Draw and cut around. I'm sorry, I forgot to cut off this area. It should be like this. Mark the dart point. Also draw the dart lines with 1 cm seam allowance like this. Thank you. Mark the dark point to other side using this method. Now, I cut the facings. Place the front neck facing to the folded edge of the fabric like this. I use the same fabric for pocket lining and for the pocket bag. But you can use a softer matching color fabric for the lining. I already fused the facings using a soft fusing. I would like to mention the sewing instructions beforehand, so that you will have a prior idea on the sewing operation. Fold the back darts at the middle. Add pins to darts and stitch along the chalk line. Add a notch to the center front neck. Add pins to bust darts like this and stitch along the line. And then join the front and back shoulders together like this. Notch the center of the front neck facing. Also join neck facings at shoulder like this. And join front armhole facing to back armhole facing at shoulder like this. Join pocket lining to front culotte. Don't forget. It is right side to right side. We will learn how to sew this garment from the next video. Thank you very much for watching.